Hey, buddy, it's Evicta. It's time for another Eat and Run here, the Binding of Isaac Evicta Repentance series. Yesterday's video has not crossed 5,000 likes yet, but the previous one did, which unlocked the next like streak goal. Down below, as you see, it's going to be the Espanol run, the Spanish mosh pit already low. And oh no! What does that mean? Well, I'll explain it when we start this run, but first off, here's your meme of the day. Brought to you by Puzzlemaster 20. Title of the thread was Meme Streak Day 14. Found this on the wall in basement too. Have you seen this person? Wanted. Yaves. One of them there. One of them there, Yaves, aka La Lave. Reward 99 cents. I mean, yeah, that's a pretty good reward, I think, for just one key. Or 3, or 10, or 99. Thank you very much, Puzzle Master. And all 206 of you who upvoted that one. Also, don't forget to tune in live tonight. About 5 hours after this episode goes live here on YouTube, I will be live doing the live AMA and Q&A session along with the tier list recording. Looking forward to seeing you all there. Here's the seed day. It's going to be 4 Juliet, Yankee, Delta, 3 Charlie, 4 Romeo. We've got IV Bag, Celtic Cross, God awful damage, pretty bad tears rate, and kind of bad movement speed. Kind of real bad movement speed. But we have IV bag, and that should get us places, right? Right? Right. So yeah, IV bag, of course, is going to take away from our red heart HP first, and after that, we're going to be taking away from the soul heart HP. Now, I'm happy that we have this red heart here because this allows us to go into and out of the secret or the curse room for free. Because what can happen is we can trigger our iframes and save the damage on our soul heart by simply taking the damage on our replenishable and easily refindable HP. Red HP. Red heart HP. Whatever you want to call it. HP containers. So walk in here. We get the red Kizzle. We about to do a red key run, y'all. The red Kizzle. Before we do that, because I do want to have a red key run. Well, I mean, if we're going to the red heart here, if we're going to do a red key run, like we might as well get it now, you know. I don't want to do it in this room because it's we're going to lose half of our soul heart, probably all of our soul heart. So the red key will spawn if we're next to a red door like we are right there, we will be able to spawn it and walk in. This one spawned a red shop. No, it's the regular shop. Interesting. So, yeah. This one also is next to I believe this is going to be the regular secret room to our left. Notice how it's not on the map, but it does have a door to it, which means it is one of the two. So, interesting. Very interesting. We also have a tinted rock here. But yeah, the red key is basically your window, your door, whatever you want to call it, your key into the red rooms. And the red rooms, of course, can have a variety of different benefits. They used to have a lot more benefit with the Ultra Secret Room, but obviously now since that's been nerfed, we don't really have a reason to go in there. There are still some good items in the Ultra Secret Room, but they have been greatly, greatly diminished in terms of like the attractiveness of it all, which is what happened to me on my 90th birthday. Trying to finagle this mulligan over there so we can maybe get him to drop a troll bomb. Nope, he didn't explode. Okay. I was hoping to explode between the secret heart or the tinted rock and the gold rock here. Get a bomb anyway, so we'll go ahead and go use our La Bamba. I'm going to leave that soul heart there and we get oh my gosh, it's the halo. At the halo, of course, is going to be a nice all stats up, which is exactly what we need to get going on this run. But yeah, so talking about the Espanol run. The Spanish mosh pit is already bracing themselves. What is that going to entail? Well, that is going to entail us playing the Binding of Isaac Repentance. I know. It's something that we never do here. But I'm going to change all of the language options to Spanish. And I'm going to have to correctly, or at least attempt to try to read everything that appears in Spanish in Spanish. Now, I know that some people are hoping that one day I'll do just an entire episode in Spanish, but I do not speak Spanish fluently or poorly. I mean, I speak it poorly, but that's about all I can do. So with that in mind, I wanted to do something that's just different. And this is certainly different than what we've done for any other like streak goal. And, you know, I figured it would just be fun. It'd be fun to do this kind of thing. Maybe in the future, you know, we can test the other language options in Isaac. Now, I do know that there is a language option, or at least there's a conversion pack for the external information mod. And for that, I need to get more information because I don't know where to get it from. By it, I mean the conversion pack from. But I will be turning that into Spanish as well. So that way there's a plethora of Spanish that we can read through. We don't have the tiers rate to really be balling with Dookie right now. So it would take us a while to get through this. And I'd happily use a bomb here. We're going to get Jesus Juice, which is going to give us a nice damage range up. We can come back and buy another bomb to get into the super secret room. Or we could buy this full charge and attempt to go for the ultra secret room, which I believe is going to be between the item room and that other room down here. I think I was correct. And whether or not this item room is going to be worth it or not is going to be beyond me. Celtic Cross proccing there. Yep. Yeah. They pretty much murdered ultra secret rooms, but hey, what do we say to that? That's repentance, baby. Curse of Lost. Yeah, so we had some really good upgrades there on floor one, getting the Halo and, of course, Jesus Juice, getting some nice damage ups. We're just now getting to the point of being over base average Isaac damage. So, you know, there's that. Good movement speed now. Tears rate still needs a little bit of work. But the red key, outside of the lack of real good options that the ultra secret rooms can give you these days, the red key can still provide you with a variety of benefits that can be very good. Particularly whenever you spawn extra item rooms, you can find angel rooms in there, you can find extra shops, dice rooms, all kinds of good stuff. So the red key is definitely a long-term play for your runs. I think that it is definitely worth using whenever you can while safely. Now we are going to get a full charge here. I don't think the ultra secret room is going to be near the item room, but it's impossible for me to know because, you know, Curse of the Lost. Maybe here? No. Now, hopefully what we can get is some kind of way. Ooh, we get a couple bombs. Hey, you know what? And it's rock bottom! Oh, baby. Let the party begin. I would have never found that secret room had it not been for the red key. Now, to be clear, the red key did not give us that secret room. That's not like a red key secret room or anything like that. That was our regular secret room. But rock bottom, my God, ensures that we don't have to worry about losing any stats anymore, basically. So it's going to be a nice little surprise for the game whenever we start taking pills, because now we don't have to worry about pills screwing us up, because it literally can't hurt us unless we get bad trip. Then it can. Also got duality out of our devil deal. Duality will open up an angel deal whenever there is one present, or vice versa. They'll open a devil deal whenever there's an angel deal. At least it will attempt to. It will attempt to. Sure. Over here, there's the other full charge. Actually, that's a mini charge there. Rock bottom, of course, one of the premier new items from Repentance. Definitely one of the most broken items, as well as just an overall, it's overall crowd pleaser. I mean, we can go in here. Maybe there's a half-price soul heart. There's not. Get a half-price alabaster box, which is just a bad idea. Not sure where the ultra secret room is. It could be left of here. We're going to check anyway. But obviously with a red key run, you want to be able to give yourself as many full charges as possible. So you're looking for stuff like Nun's Habit, like the jumper cables. Didn't actually mean to buy that, but here we are. Jumper cables are very easily one of the best ones you can get. I mean, you could use Sharp Plug if you really want to, but you got to be careful with that, obviously. So destroy these fires while we're in here. Looking for a tears up. Hopefully we have a tears up pill in the pill pool.
I found pills.
If this is like a damage up, we can also use it. It's a temperance machine. I think I'm just going to drop it and pop it. And get absolutely nothing for it. All right. All right. Now, with us taking duality, this means that we are not going to see an angel deal, obviously, because we're floor two. And I love these things. They're so cool. I am not going to lose a soul heart on on this mimic chest here. Mm-hmm. So we can get, no, we can't. I just used our bomb. I was hoping that we were going to get a nickel there. So if we do see another tenant rock or something like that, maybe we can find another bomb to buy. Gemini is going to be a little bit of a pain here, but luckily we did get that movement speed upgrade, which is going to help us out quite a bit. So what are we looking for rock bottom? Really anything that has any kind of negative trait or a penalty, like say quad shot, inner eye, soy milk, you know, kidney stone, anything like that, Eve's mascara, etc. We're going to be looking for that because we don't have to worry about the negatives of that item anymore. And that being said, if we get something like soy milk that doesn't cancel out the I guess I could have taken that with rock bottom, no. That doesn't cancel out the negative attributes. So with using soy milk, for example, if we were to find soy milk, we would still get the minus 30% to all damage downs that we would see, but we wouldn't lose damage at the start. Does that make sense? Whenever you acquire soy milk, you lose that damage almost automatically. It is automatic as soon as you pick it up. Now, we will not lose that damage, but we still are afflicted by the negative damage multiplier with soy milk. If we were to get damage up, all of it gets rounded down to 30% of whatever we would have gotten. And that is something that Rock Bottom does not take care of for you. I guess here. Oh, okay. Well, I give up. So very, very awesome second floor here. A little bit of the longer floor, but we were able to get rock bottom. And, you know, that is a huge, huge get. Big time get. We'll even go so far as to call that a big time play. Double soul hearts. This will allow me to go back into the curse room now. I wasn't 100% sold on going into the curse room, but now I am. And boy, howdy, am I happy I did. Mm-hmm. Yeehaw, cowboy. Our bomb back. Yeah, I think we're just going to head on down. So excellent second floor. Like I said, a little bit of on the longer side here, but with given all the red key shenanigans and tomfoolery, that's to be expected. Apparently, we're going to have one more full charge because this is just the largest floor two that's ever floor two'd ever. So if I were the ultra secret room, where would I be? I'd be right here. All right. Oh, no, it's probably somewhere over there. I can't be asked. Not be bothered. And we are going to head on Dizown. Thank you. Looking forward to seeing everyone tonight for the AMA. And hopefully, if you didn't see it, because I posted it kind of late last night, it was right after midnight, check out the community feed. That's the only place, unless you're on the Discord, that you will find it outside of the Discord. You can submit your own questions to the AMA. And I put a little disclaimer out there that, you know, I won't be answering anything inappropriate. Basically, I reserve the right. Wow, that was a fast cut there by the maggot. Basically, I reserve the right to refuse to answer something if it's something to say like, what's your social security number, or, you know, how big are your feet, or, you know, something dumb like that. You know, I'll just be glancing over those. And if I do end up skipping your question, definitely don't take it personal. It was probably a repeat question, or it was a question I just didn't want to answer. So, but I highly encourage you all to come and at least check it out. If you're not interested in that, then stay tuned after the AMA for what we'll be doing. We'll probably do the AMA for about an hour or so. And then after that, we're going to be going on into the live tier list recording. What am I gonna rank next? Which ones of the meta am I gonna break up next? Because I'm such a trendsetter. Well, I'll let you know whenever we are on the air. Gotta be careful of the champion globe in here. Definitely need some tiers ups for show. Our damage upgrades are looking quite healthy, especially with growth hormones. Just firing off the cuff here, and we went into a room that I absolutely hate. Movement speed is very important in this little showdown here with these hosts. If you have enough movement speed, you're able to very quickly and accurately get around those shots and then run right up to the host right before they can fire again. And that's where you want to be. We've got a temperance machine here, which will give us a little bit more moolah. Hoping that Celtic Cross would proc off of that so we can get a little bit of extra money for the shop. Maybe it still can. We know that the super secret room is not going to be above here because, well, there's a red door. Golden key is going to, or golden chest, I should say, give us 4 cents out of here. Not the worst trade. I mean, you trade 4 cents for basically one key in the store. Obviously the base cost of a key is 5 cents, but 4 cents, yeah, you know, it's all right. Not the best trade, but we lose a cent out on that. We got a key back anyway, so it's no big deal. And just looking for our item room or boss room, or, you know, anything of note, anything noteworthy. Super secret room is also not to the left of here because, again, for the aforementioned reason, we can see a door, which means that there is not the presence of a secret room there. E7, no thank you. Never on a Saturday. Everyone's super excited to see rock bottom. The crowd goes wild. Hopefully that we find some kind of synergy with all the crazy items. Rock bottom runs can get very, very crazy very quickly. Rock bottom runs, you make the rockin' world go round. A little bit too close for comfort right there. One's got one more shot left. This one... new one, that one right there. There we go. There, yeah, it was that one. Lost it in the sauce. Swallow penny. Swallow penny with that temperance machine might be kind of pogged. Definitely would love to get that. And secret room should be there. Which means we can bomb our way into the cursed room. Matchsticks can give us some bombs here. All takeable. And we get the... So if you don't know what just happened there, we bounced off of the chest and got kicked out of the devil deal. Hopefully we can get back in there and get Twisted Pair, otherwise I'm going to be real mad. I've never understood why chests with items have like a knockback. I really don't. We just dropped a cardio coin. I didn't know that could happen. Try this again. Okay, we did it. He's done it. Twisted Pair is a get. We get divorce papers, which is going to give us a nice tears up as well. Now, we can buy this full charge, or we can walk. We can walk over to the other room here. I think this is just a steel chest. Yeah, we don't need to do that. Twisted Pair, of course, is going to give us a multi-shot at the cost of a little bit of damage, but still worth it, of course. We can get another full charge here out of the mob trap room. Didn't really want to do it in here, but if we get a full charge here and then we can go into the we can go into the shop and buy that other full charge. So fill that red heart here, and I don't think it's here, but I'm gonna try. Okay, so not gonna go out of the curse room. Every single door that you open into or out of a curse room from a red key entryway is going to be costing you some H Pizzle. There's a temperance machine in here as well. Out the cross, you're failing me. Fail me in a big way, son. Oh, baby. All right. That worked out pretty well. Even if Celtic Cross didn't actually proc at all, that still worked out to be great. I could go play the other one, but meh. Got ourselves a library here. It's known as La Biblioteca. The Spanish mosh pit cringes. Either that or honestly, like the Spanish mosh pit are some of the most loving members of the mosh pit. I'm a big fan of the Spanish mosh pit, as everyone knows. So one of my all-time favorite memes to come out of this series has been the Nada mal niño. Love that one. All right, so let's go check. Let's just go get this out of the way and check off of the side of the library. I figured it wasn't here, but I wanted just to be sure. It's the beginning of the level anyway, and we're bound to get this full charge back. Not going to go in the curse room yet until we have a red heart that we can refill our red key or our bone heart with. In the rock, trying to hide up here. I see you. I see you. We might be able to bomb our way into... Nope. Vaults just aren't worth it, man. They're just not. Actually surprised we didn't get a single dark grub out of that. This is a dangerous room right here. Gotta watch out for that. The corpse explosion from these guys are what gets you, gives you the fits. Puberty. One day we'll get hopefully a positive pill. And we're taking pills here because they can't really negatively affect us. We're going to have a full charge for this corner over here, which maybe... Nope. That will get us into the item room for free, so it saves us a key. We actually gained a key out of that, and there's that item. Good. Hoping that we get something really wacky and crazy, like get some flying here or get like a nice planetarium item out of the red key doors. We've already gained so much benefit, or I mean theoretical benefit anyway, because obviously we're not getting any premier items right now. Like, rock bottom hasn't really had a chance to truly shine outside of us taking a couple pills that were bad anyway. So we want like quad shot, we want Polyphemus, we want to use mascara. Something with some serious repercussions that we don't have to worry about. Fool card teleports us back. And it's just gonna be another fool card, alright. Alright. Go check out, got some mini strobes in here. I kind of wish that the red key worked like the Soul of Cain does, where it just opens up all red doors, but that might be too powerful, I suppose. We wouldn't want that in Isaac. No. Can we stop getting mimic chests? Because that's pretty sure that's the third one in a row that we've seen here, game. And we're going to be looking for cards here. World card is, I mean, it's not the one that we're looking for, but world card will give us the entire map outside of the super secret room. I don't really want to use our last bomb here. I guess we can use a key. We've got plenty of keys, and we still need to go back into the vault in the curse room anyway. So a super secret room should be north of here, maybe. I don't know how many spike chests that is now, but that is quite a bit. Super secret room. Yep. Let's save this bomb for the cursed room in case there's a stone chest in there that we need to explode. Wow. It's like no wind-up time at all. He just came right out of there just immediately. Kind of like that. Apparently Frail just can accelerate the rate that he gets out of the ground. He's near you. Get stem cells. Do we give Stanley a chance? I mean, he's already given us, you know, Twisted Pear. I'm going to give the Angel Deals a chance to shine here. This is your only chance, though. Angelic Prism is not my top pick. It's not a terrible item. It's just not one of those items that, like, you want to see on a rock bottom run. You know, you want to get something crazy. Okay, good. We have the key piece, which will boost our angel deal chance by a little bit anyway, which there in turn also boosts our devil deal chance. You get a red heart so we can fill up this bone heart. Go check out the vault real quick. Yeah, there's a charge key in there. Yeah, Angelic Prism, there's nothing horrible about it. Like, there's no downsides at all to it. It's just not what we wanted. Like, we want something spectacular out of there. Red key. We get a planetarium that has Neptunus. I'm going to be honest. I don't like Neptunus. Straight up, I think the charge shot mechanic is annoying. And I don't think that it gives us a fantastic upside. Not with Rock Bottom. If we didn't have Rock Bottom, I would definitely consider it. But because I don't like the charge up, it really depends on what your tiers rate is. If your tiers rate is high enough, the Neptunus can be okay. I still find that the wind up time per shot is kind of annoying. It is nice to rattle off those shots for sure, but again, we have Rock Bottom, and I think that Rock Bottom keeps us from needing something like that, because our tiers rate is going to be so high that we just don't care. That's assuming that we can actually get something that, like, you know, like soy milk, almond milk, etc., etc. Really, the biggest prize that you're looking for right now, if you need tiers up or any type of fire rate up, is going to be Kidney Stone, which we do not have yet. Super long, super duper long run. 28 minutes, and we're only on depths one. Eesh. Lots of faffing about, though, whenever it comes to a red key run, of course. Please. The damage is certainly becoming a problem now. As you can see here, 5.25 is not enough to really bring down the house. Scorpio's not bad, but not what we want. Get a Wrath fight in here, which should give us a couple of bombs anyway. Maybe even Mr. Mega, that would be great. Or literally the worst that it could have possibly been. All right. And we just get a random haunt fight in here as well. Gotta love them scorpion tears. Scorpio tears. Gonna put a little bit of a poison effect every now and then with a little bit of a cooldown. A little bit of diminishing return factor. I wouldn't mind getting tarot cloth if we can get it cheap. And that's about as cheap as it can get. Stars card, okay. Botfly, I'm not really big into Botfly. Botfly is not terrible, of course, but we don't know how much money it's going to cost us, and we don't want to spend a whole lot, especially if our shop is good. Yeah, there's a fool card there, but we already have a fool card. Can you see the poison damage there really doing its work? thought I was going to get hit there, didn't you? You had no faith in poor old Sinvicta for making that diagonal leap, did you? And we're still looking for that shop is all we're looking for here. Nothing crazy. We found it. All right, we got it. These maps have been quite something the last couple of days. Horse pill. Okay. Definitely want to get some flying here if we can. Lots of potential for Pog. Bound Soul doesn't really help us out that much. There's a Tinted Rock in here, though. So getting Small Rock would definitely be something that we would want. Not only for the damage, but obviously we don't have to worry about the movement speed down anymore because of Rock Bottom. Let's get more bombs and a Soul Heart. Soul Heart's been flowing like water. And we get a Forget Me Now, which allows us to restart the floor. So we'll use that after we're done with the boss. But first, let's go into our curse room here. And we can go pretty hard on this Demon Judgment, especially with Gimpy and Swallow Penny and Celtic Cross. Basically, no way that this doesn't pay out for us. So, Hermit card. We get Science, aka Little Horn. Botfly and the D10. No, I don't think we'll be doing that. Super Seeker Rune. Yeah. Okay, we got another Temperance Machine here, so we can get that money back, plus a lot more. Gonna go again pretty hard on this because we've got Swallowed Penny and Celtic Cross, as you see that damage shield proc right there. We also got Gimpy just pan out like candy. There we go. Good amounts of money there. Really, really good. So we got a 45% chance now for a deal with the angel or deal with the devil. It's going to be double champion. These are actually double champions because they're small and they're pink. I don't know how we didn't take damage there. Cage literally went in between me and one of the twins and we didn't take damage. I mean, I ain't gonna complain, but that's crazy. Little Horn doing its thing over there, smacking around the pink cage. And we failed the 45%. Not to be all that surprising. Luck down. Well, unfortunately for you, game, we've got Rock Bottom. Rock Bottom, girls, you make the rockin' world go round. All right. Oh, I forgot about the 5 room. Oh, well. He forgot the 5 room, Grandpa. Yo. He's like you. Yeah. In recompense, I don't know if that's the correct term used for that, but in recompense for missing or forgetting about the 5 room, I shall do a victory lap, because I gotta say that this first lap here, this first run is just, it's not good. It's not a good Rock Bottom run, and it's just not a good anything. Also, there's no red doors apparently on this level. Happy that we got Botfly, though. There's a size down. Four cards gonna give us a crawl space. She gives us sad bombs, which ain't bad at all. It ain't bad, but they are sad. Escalitis, it's not very good, but we'll take it anyway. Although Vasculitis did have quite a crazy run against Beast. What was the Beast run that we did with Vasculitis where it was literally just Vasculitis that was doing damage to Beast? Magic Skin here, I'd prefer not. Magic Skin tends to ruin a lot of things. There was a very low damage run it was a fairly recent run where Vasculitis was like the only reason why we were actually killing Beast. And I didn't give it enough credit. Let me know in the comments down below which episode that was, or just let me know in the AMA. So we've got enough to put back in the donation machine, which we might as well do right now. We can also bomb the keeper and get ready to fail another 73% roll. Look at that. We're back almost. We're almost at a $10 right now. That's really good. Grandpa! Grandpa, get ready! Wake up! He's about to do it, Grandpa! That guy, you know? Remember I told you about him? Remember you're on Reddit? Yeah, that guy. He's about to fail another 73%. Let's go. Actually didn't mean for that bomb to hit mom, but hey. Oh, whatever. We actually did get the devil deal. You know, normally I would take mom's knife, especially with rock bottom. But I don't think, and like also doubly, especially with the twins, but I don't think that the fool. I don't think that gives us an interesting run with rock bottom. Rock bottom can seriously go crazy. Like, we do need damage. Like, don't get me wrong. We need damage. Right now, damage is of the essence, to which we have none. And obviously, if we had mom's knife, we could potentially ball out of control with it. But I don't think that it is as interesting without mom's knife as that would be. So this is one of the few times where I don't think that taking mom's knife gives us a more interesting run, even though we definitely need it. We can do better with what we've got, which is rock bottom, and that's all we really need. I also just kind of wish that the golden coin would just give you the... In one aspect, I wish it would just give you the total amount that you're due to receive from it. But I understand the reason why it needs to be like a single drop, because obviously if you have something like the Crooked Penny, Burnt Penny, et cetera, something that operates off of getting coins, then yeah. You know, you're gonna wanna pick up as many coins as possible individually so you can gain those benefits. I guess the way that I would change it is to make it to where the coins don't move around so much. Where are we gonna go? Yeah. To me it looks like it's off of the arcade. in between the arcade and the boss trap room is what it looks like to me. And he'd be correct. Eye of Belial. Now that is a run. That's a run changer right there. Pageant Boy is not. So we get our first good Ultra Secret Room item out of the run. Almost did it again. And at 41 minutes, we're ready to go down to Utero 1. Yeah, buddy. And Curse of the XL. Burm, 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 burm. Well, Curse of the XL will definitely make things go faster. Especially with us going in the wrong direction, of course. Eye of Belial, of course, is going to do that and just basically lay waste to everything and their mother. No Tinted Rock in here. Very surprising. The actual explanation of what Eye of Belial does is that we'll pierce through the first target, and anything that the tier travels through and hits next will be dealt double damage, essentially. You can see why I don't like Vasculitis, though, because it does not differentiate what's incoming damage and what's outgoing damage. So you could inadvertently dodge one of your own shots and run into a shot that was not meant for you. And I have a problem with that. Not gonna go in the curse room. I think it's a little bit too expensive for us right now. And so far, I gotta say, this has been pretty much one of the most disappointing rock bottom runs that we've seen. I feel like the last time we got rock bottom too was not very good. Finally get a damage up here. And this should be all systems go for It Lives. Good damage up there with the pentagram. That definitely helps out. Botfly doing your thing. I appreciate that. I like what you're bringing to this organization, this team. I need you to keep it up, son. We're going to need you. We're going to need you. The Pogatory and the Sister Maggie. We'll take some Pogatory and head on down. Now, what would be cool, and this would be an awesome buff for Purgatory if they ever decided to buff something in this game, I would love to have the ability to shoot the Purgatory crack instead of having to physically walk over it. I think that'd be a neat change, but obviously it would make Purgatory maybe a little bit too strong. I don't know. Maybe. Fortune Telling Machine, we can get some HP back. Or we can just blow it up. That's fine, too. And you're seeing the burst damage there whenever all of the babies combine through Angelic prism. And I mean, vasculitis does, it does a good amount of damage whenever you've got a lot of enemies grouped up. But I didn't turn that way. There's a super secret room. Definitely going to play for some HP here. Compass will also take, so we can ensure that we get 39% more Curse of the Lost. Looking forward to that. We will get one full charge here off of Stanley for the red key. Purgatory. All right, thanks for showing up. There we go. Now again, Purgatory is also a fantastic defensive item just because it can be used to destroy shots on targets. So between Purgatory and Botfly, we should be pretty immune to projectiles, unless of course Stanley does like the most pro prediction ever and shoots brimstone directly down on top of us. Here's that bone heart that was so important. Ooh boy. Oh, I found a store. All right. So hold on to your butts, everybody, because we've got ourselves a wild ride to end it. All right, show us the good stuff. Brimstone would definitely be good. You pretty much have to take Empty Vessel first, though. Brimstone, we're coming back for you. Don't you worry. We can get Brimstone now, but I've got to be careful. I guess we could take Brimstone now, I suppose. That would take us down to 2 HP, though. So we, as you see, we don't get the usual tears down from Brimstone anymore. I don't know what just hit me there. Yeah, vasculitis is really, really dangerous. I'm reminded why I don't take the item now. This is kind of the reason why I did not want to take Brimstone yet, anyway. It just takes one errant bad shot to put us down to 1 HP, and that's not good. I found pills. So we're looking for some HP here. That would be over here. Half of a soul heart is very important. Half of a soul heart right there. You can definitely do some brim snapping here. Volatar is excellent for crowd control. You know, good damage there on Brownie. You find the Ultra Seeker Room, which is kind of difficult to do, kind of really difficult to do in the dark chest. It gives us meat. So I think we can use the Emperor card now. Is that enough to take on Lamb? Well, it's going to have to be. We're going to get ourselves a soul heart because we have the We have the tarot cloth. Yep, that's movement speed right there, folks. Thank you, Gimpy, as well as Celtic Cross. Purgatory doing a good job at canceling out a lot of the shots. And down he goes. All right, second run. Eight, yaha. Go back, Papa, 2-2. So a little bit of a spicy end there to cap off that run. But, you know, a clutch, super clutch Ultra Secret Room definitely helped out a lot with meat. Two free bombs here. We'll gladly take that. Secret room might be to the right of the boss room that we were just in there with Pride. Now that was a satisfying room, y'all. That was definitely a satisfying room. Very happy to have the compass as well. But as you can see with rock bottom, we're just able to just fire on all cylinders with all the brimstones. It does make for a lot of visual doo-doo on the screen. I do acknowledge that. But whenever you do have the ability to get the to get the prism involved, like that's when brimstone's damage really starts taking off. Get the eternal de-sizzle, which I will use on this item pedestal. All right. Yeah, I'm still looking for like a strength card or something like that. Anything that gives us a damage upgrade or a devil card, really. I mean, we haven't really had a good opportunity to get any great advantages off of rock bottom, except for the fact that brimstone is not being affected by our tears rate. An eternal heart here. Yes. Yep. Getting better at recognizing the patterns. There's our strength card. Finally, we get some. Oh! Never mind. Just kidding. We got ourselves Sacred Heart inside of the Ultra Secret Room, coach. Oh, baby. Now we're talking repentance, baby. The crowd goes wild. I hear you cheering, Mosh Pit. My goodness. Sacred Heart, Brimstone without any downside. And look at that. We were just on fire finding these ultra secret rooms. And then, yeah, let's just get money equals power, too. Holy Toledo. Just all of a sudden. And we look at that, we even get ourselves the jumper cables that we were hoping for and wished for. Yeah. Sackhead's going to give us more sacks, which means hopefully more charges as well. Man, oh man, where was this run on the first run? Seriously. Flying Rage? Nah. Found Soul. Still think Found Soul is not very good. Oh my god. Do we want... No, let's stick to Devil Deals. We have Bloody Lust, which, I mean, or Lusty Blood, and that's just going to give us even more damage to tack on. Those of you looking at the thumbnail, you're like, if you're wondering where the heck was the Sacred Heart? Well, there you go. Now you found it. Maw the Vizoid as well. We get Leviathan. My goodness. Everything just all of a sudden coming up Millhouse. Purity is even better for Rock Bottom because we don't have to worry about losing the stat-ups that we get. That is, again, where was this run... Where was this run when we started? It took us an hour and 1 minute to get to where we are now. I know we did get a full charge there, or at least part of a full charge anyway. Death card, Queen of Hearts. Converter. Converter, I didn't even know her. Restizzle. Maybe. Get a bedroom here, which is not going to do anything for us. It's a dirty bedroom. I doubt there's a crawl space under there. That goes the clog. We get ourselves another tears up, which we don't even need really at this point. And we are just brutalizing everything here. I don't really care about restock. That's definitely crazy. And also a little trollish, I gotta be honest, for all of a sudden it just to pop off like this. Yeah, we weren't exactly like, you know, hurting or anything in this run, but we were definitely fiending for some kind of satisfaction with us getting rock bottom. And now the moment is at hand. We do get a sack off of the off of sack head here. There's a charge key and another sack. So we're going to get free entry into the boss trap room here. I don't think this does anything for us, but we'll just take it anyway. Another full charge here, thanks to the... It's the jumper cables. Super lust, super dead. And this is the reason why I said you want a jumper cable is just to feed yourself more and more opportunities to get full charges. And the more red rooms you get, the higher the chances that you're going to get something incredible. And that is definitely for sure what happened here. Paralysis, no thank you. Okay. The Curse of the Maze now. And definitely forget everything I said about Ultra Seeker Rooms being nerfed. Apparently, I didn't know that they kept Sacred Heart in there. We do get Perfection, which is going to give us our luck up. Take a little chat as well. And oh my goodness, the shots just keep on multiplying here. And with 13 luck now, whew, we are looking powerful. First or lost, who cares? Use diaper, no thank you. I don't know if this is a red item room or just a regular item room. Looks to be a red item room. I think the swarm here is going to give us probably Beelzebub, or at least two of three for Beelzebub. Lucky Rock, meh. That's another nice little feature about Red Key, is that if you, even if you don't find the right way to go in terms of like where the Ultra Seeker room is or whatever, you still might give yourself a bonus path to where you need to go without you having to like clear a secret room or anything like that. Plum Floop. Oh, there's no button in there. I was like, why are the doors opening? So it's a dime. And we have finally caught up to where our money needs to be for Money Equals Power to start giving us upgrades again. Did you see the double science dunk there? The double little horn dunk with that, the stone host. That was incredible. I'm down with that. Okay, so purgatory does not affect them. So what would happen if we just what would happen there if we just didn't if we didn't have bombs, game? Would we just get soft locked? Apparently you can destroy those statues. I didn't know that. Back up to the land of the living here. You can call this living. Tears down again. Not going to affect us. I don't think that we've gotten a single positive pill. Oh, man. And I don't think I've ever seen so many multi-shot abilities possible that aren't, that wasn't quad shot or inner eye. Cardio coin, I'm over it. There we go. There's the Ultra Seeker room. It gives us Lord of the Pit, which is going to give us increased flying speed. Oh, we're already maxed. I mean, it's increased speed. It's not increased. There's no such thing as a difference between movement speed and flying speed. They're all the same thing. It increases our speed and also gives us flying if we didn't already have it and if we weren't already capped. So might as well go to the store since we've got plenty of money. And again, we don't need to worry about our damage going down because of rock bottom. Thanks to Money Equals Power not being able to trigger off of that. Oh, man. And we get ourselves a 9-volt coach. And a judgment card as well. Okay. So that's going to take us to the IMR room. We don't want to go in there yet. We can use this judgment card inside of the boss rush, but then we would have to find a way to get out of there. Maybe we might do with the red key. Who knows? Brimstone's still showing you why it's the king of clear. King of clear speed. We even get our bookworm transformation as well. Oh, man. Things are just getting out of control now in this run. Oof. Oof. Get 9 lives and death's list as well. Let's take a look here. So host hat, you know, host hat ain't bad for the explosions. I want to say we can do better though. Toxic shock is very good, but that denies us a lot of our fun. Brittle bones, another Celtic cross, nah. I don't think tractor beam and tech tizzle do anything for us here. Okay. Okay. Holy light. Yeah, this is starting to look pretty rock bottomy here. If you thought the Mega Satan kill, the Mega Satan or the Mega Blast boss rush was crazy looking, look out. I think this is what we call deleted in the industry. We're just deleting these bosses. Yeah, that was not even close. Fortunately, we can't get out of here though, so we're gonna have to head on down. Where's the blind? Who cares? It's been a wild ride this run, and hopefully you all enjoyed it. It's a great way to get ready for the AMA tonight. And I hope to see you all there. It's going to be a great time. Immaculate Heart as well, man. Look at us. Look at us becoming a regular old ultra secret finder, room finder. I think I've got it down now. Immaculate Heart plus this build is just, I mean, this isn't even fair at this point. Which is fine, because, I mean, who wants to be fair to repentance? Am I right? You shouldn't. You shouldn't want to be. Anytime you get the opportunity to kick the game square in the teeth, definitely do it. Because it definitely deserves it. Now, normally, I'd say I'd be up for going for an Omega run opportunity here, but I am going to try to save my voice for the AMA, because it's going to be a talkative stream. Apparently there was a secret room over here I didn't even know about. Get the DN fizzle. Say thank you to the Red Key. Seriously, it's been a pleasure and an honor. We thank you for everything you've done. Without the Red Key, none of this run would have happened. Hands down, none of it would have happened. On the Ultra Seeker Room here, or the regular Seeker Room, I should say. If you're wondering how we're getting into these doors, it's because of sulfuric acid, by the way. Evil charm. Sulfuric acid is allowing us to bomb through these walls. Oh yeah. Just looking for an opportunity to get a full charge game, that's all. Now you don't have to despawn all the enemies on me, you know. And take the beating like a champ. Trying to give it the old college try here with re-rolling that item pedestal inside of the secret room. But, you know, if the game doesn't want to play ball, then it just doesn't want to play ball. Green card. Oh, man, we get the crystal key, too. Well, now I feel bad about getting rid of the red key, because that would have been double the amount of opportunities to find craziness. The crystal key is going to open up red doors randomly. No angel deal. Take our blood of the martyr here. Ah, I should have fought him. If I would have fought him, we would have had a full charge on the D and Fizzle. Let's go see old Hushy. Old Hushy. Go ahead and take holy water. Parasitoid as well. Although luck, I'm not sure if that would have been better for us or not. With our luck and tough love, hermit card. This run's definitely got it all. Listen to Holy Light just fire off. I'm not even going to give Hush an opportunity to attack. Down goes old Hush. And we're going again. This run ends with old Beastie. My God, I've never seen so many explosions at one time. Crybaby. Actually did get a red door. We're just going to keep getting... Ultra Secret Rooms here. Even when we're not trying to. We're definitely going to go back and reroll that because we could possibly get some more goodies out of the Ultra Secret Room like Jell-O. It's kind of amazing that we don't even have Guppy yet either in this run. I'm kind of just letting Littlehorn just execute everything. If it can, of course. Apparently, Littlehorn does not execute these. We're going to go one more time to go reroll this here Ultra Seeker Room at him. Candy Hearts, kind of meh. Oh my gosh. Fallen actually got deleted. Like, it didn't even split into the second phase. Down goes regular Stanley. Oh boy, it's getting spicy. Central Spirit, Succubus, the Pact is what we're looking for. Didn't even know the secret room was there, but we blew a hole through it. And, yeah, I guess we can go back and re-roll the chests here. Why not? What are we looking for at this point? I don't know. What do we even need? Do we even need anything in this run? I don't think so. I mean, when we can one-shot those bastards, then you know that we're looking great. Crystal key opening up here. Appreciate it, bro. Appreciate it. Oh, Monstro, how you doing? Not exactly sure how we're supposed to get to the west side over here. Guess we go down and around. Yeah, that is one dead lamb. One more time. Let's see how many items we lose. It took away our rock bottom. Of course it did. Zulu Romeo Victor 8. Lima Zulu 7 kilo. Took away rock bottom and also took away the twins. But we maintained Brimstone and Sacred Heart and Immaculate Heart and Pogatory. So still could have been worse, but hey, you know, it's that's repentance, baby. Yeah, so if you didn't know, whenever you're on a second victory lap, you do lose items. The game takes them away from you. We'll take school bag. We'll take Diplopia. I'm hoping that we do find rock bottom again, because I really miss my rapid fire brimstone that we had. My God. Two hearts. Did we lose? We also lost deep pockets, which also kind of sucks. But what can you do? I do wish that there was just an endless mode where you could, you know, you yourself could decide whether or not you lose items. You get like extra points or something for those of you who still care about points in Isaac. Because I think that an endless run mode would be pretty neat, just to see how many laps people are willing to do. You know, see how high people can get on that. Now make it like Risk of Rain. Why not do that? Make it like Risk of Rain, where you do have a, it progressively gets harder and harder, but not in a sense that it takes away all your items from you. You know, enemies get tougher. You get more enemies to the point where you start doing the Dad's Home Challenge. Dad's Home Plus, I should say. I think all that would be pretty neat. Brainworm gonna give us almost a 90 degree brimstone. I also totally spaced on the devil deal. I didn't mean to walk out there. I know we did, but like I didn't mean to. It's crystal key opening up some extra red door love for us. We'll get a not red shop. The blanket's pretty good. I just like to destroy this. Charge key. We got the membership shop real quick. Nothing spectacular. Dude. Yeah, we'll take the 120 volt. Left hand could give us some benefit here if we're looking, if we're still looking to try to get Guppy, but obviously we don't really need Guppy at this point. We're cruising, we're vibing. Is that what the kids say? They say they're vibing. Huh. Absolutely dominated. Here's our devil deal again. Vengeful Spirit, not very good. I mean, it makes you want to take damage. This is not a build that we needed to be doing that on, like at all. Get another left hand because I mean, why not? I don't really want an HP upgrade at this point. Could use some movement speed. Obviously, with that rock bottom, we're now starting to realize how bad our movement speed really is. And we were spoiled. We had it so good. Back in the before times of non-rock bottom. And now we're really sad that we don't have rock bottom. Holly, freaking Femus, Sacred Heart, Brimstone. Woof. That is a... That's an impressive amount of damage that we are dishing out. Yeah. Get another devil deal here, just passing them left and right. I really need Spirit of the Night. If we had gotten movement speed out of it, though, I would have taken it. Justice. Oh, you know what? It took away our tarot cloth as well. I didn't realize that. Tears rate definitely hurting because of Polyphemus, but the damage is just... Should still have Brim... Yeah, we should still have Bookworm. The plan is that we're going to use Diplopia in the boss rush and then D6 if we need to. Once we get there, I mean... Definitely go check out the membership card club real quick. Never know what kind of goodies they have down there. Unless, of course, you buy a 5-cent bomb that you didn't need. Little Lazarus, no thank you. Yeah, so we're going to Diplopia the boss rush. We have our moon card so we can get out of there and then go fight old Beastie afterwards. Maybe have a shot at getting rock bottom again. I probably wouldn't Genesis this run, even though like that would be a lot of fun. I mean, this run's already kind of running pretty long here. Get blue cap, which is going to give us a tears up. Slight one at that, and head on down. So let's go straight to the boss. Already go off. There it is. There's our Ultra Secret Room again. Still just finding these, and we get Berserk. I don't like Ocular Rift either, to be honest. I like Berserk, don't get me wrong, but we don't really need it. Another red door opening here. Oh no, that was a regular one. That was to the regular secret room. Regular super secret room, I should say. Alright, Diplopia is at the ready. So we're just gonna take another Polaroid here. Oh man, what a boss rush. And Jacob's ladder's up there too. Oh baby. So we're going to Diplopia. We're definitely going to take Jacob's Ladder, 100%. Now, there's Capricorn over here. I think it's more fun to reroll this, though. Dark Bomb, Holy Mantle, Quad Shot. Man, Rock Bottom, I wish you were here to see this. So our Tears Rate is not going to change at all. Because it's already pretty low. Got a moon card out of there. And, man. We may have lost Rock Bottom, but we are still really, really strong. Alabaster Box. I mean, we could take it. Yeah, sure. Revelation. Well, why not? You know, why not? You know, when you got the run that has everything, why not just get everything? A half price revelation with Polyphemus. Oh man, this is quite insane. I don't think you all understand how bad we're going to destroy this game. Like, just get ready, because, man, old Beastie is going to be old Deddy. We don't care about the item room. We don't care about the shop. We're just going straight for it. But obviously, if you're playing along with the seed and you want to take your time. My God. If you want to take your time with this run and enjoy it and, you know, just have a super overpowered broken run, by all means, don't let my YouTube schedule thing, you know, ruin your enjoyment. There's no rush in this. These are the type of runs that you just want to savor, want to enjoy them. Just have an all around just grand old time. You really don't get runs like this that often. Let's eat too much Taco Bell. Self-destructive and disturbed. Like his father. Look at who he has to look up to. You're drunk again, aren't you?
Shut up, Matt. Shut up. Just keep pushing me like this. I'm leaving.
Good. Leave. We'll be fine without you.
It's gonna be over here. Obviously, Ipecac is gonna slow us down quite a bit because we gotta be careful with the self-inflicted damage. But it's not of a concern. There's quite literally no way that we lose this. I gotta say that the quad shot brimstone revelation, whenever it goes off like together, like simultaneously, it looks incredible. Range upgrade is gonna be very useful for us. Thank you, Gimpy. Probably do a little bit of a better job at getting around to the to one side of a room Oh, actually, apparently mind worm or brain worm will just hit both sides. Oh gosh. We are making this game look stupid. And up we go.
I just can't do this anymore. I'm sorry.
Please, please don't leave us.
I'm sorry, Isaac.
Mom's key. Probably should have re-rolled that. Oh, well. All right, well, get ready for the biggest smackdown on Dogma that you probably have seen or maybe haven't seen in quite a while. It's not going to be the fastest Dogma kill because we don't have Rock Bottom. Had we kept Rock Bottom and had all of these insane items, definitely would have been destruction of an untold degree. But, yeah, we're still going to absolutely smash Dogma. That'll do her. So thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you click the like button and don't forget to check out the live AMA coming up today in about 3.5 hours from now. All you gotta do is just subscribe to the channel, ring the notification bell so you get notified when that goes live here on the channel. And again, thank you all very much for making it possible. I'm gonna name off the Patreon patrons now so I can call tonight and give you the full sound effects of the beast fight. Thank you to Topper Morrison, Jim, Harry Jim, Mandy Umel, Lots Callen, Kent Castaney, Greeby, and Joseph Whitfield. Thank you all very much for watching again. Thank you for liking, commenting, subscribing. Enjoy the beast run. See ya for the live AMA tonight, starting at 5 p.m. Central, 6 p.m. Eastern, 3 p.m. Pacific Standard Time.
Smiting the mother of harlots asunder and setting the blood lake to